A lot of his expressions don't make sense. Okay.
If the world were perfect, it wouldn't be.
Louder, Ollie.
If the people don't want to come out to the ballpark, nobody's gonna stop them.
Yeah, he's contradicting himself. If the people don't want to come to the ballpark, nobody's gonna stop them.
No one's gonna make them.
I know, he doesn't use the words exactly right. And you know what I'm attributing it to? His lack of education, because he stopped school in eighth grade.
And wasn't a good student.
So probably he doesn't really know how to use words that well, although his expressions have become famous. Okay.
When Yogi started playing baseball, there was no special gloves protection. As Yogi and others played baseball, they invented new tools for the game. Gloves and chest protectors and helmets, that type of stuff, because it hurt their hands to get hit with the ball. And you can guys feel the thing.
Okay, that's a real myth. Tell us, Ari. Are you finished?
Yeah.
Okay, why is it important to learn about Yogi Berra as a New Jerseyan? Ari, why do you think he's a good role model?
Because he tried his hardest every time.
Tell the class.
Yeah, because he tried his hardest every time.
Okay. And he also had a dream. This was a boy whose parents were immigrants to this country. He had to stop school at eighth grade to go out and support his family. He's not the kind of person who had the luxury to just play sports. He had to go out and work. So the fact that he could follow his dream of becoming a famous ball player, it was really a one in a million shot that he got there. And he really had to stick to it.
Hello, everybody. My name is Thomas Alvarezson. I'm going to tell you about my life. I was born on February 11, 1847. To Nancy Elliott Edison and Samuel Edison in the little town of Millen, Ohio. I was the seventh child, but three children died infants. I was not a very good student in school, and by the age of seven, I got kicked out. My mom realized that I was smart and taught me herself. I really liked all science subjects, and I would do many experiments, but after a few years, I was forced to work because experiments were getting too expensive. I got a job as a newspaper seller on the train. One time, I saved a kid from a train, and his dad gave me a job as a telegrapher. As a telegrapher, I got fired from many jobs, so I decided to become a full-time inventor. I started my own telegraph company shortly after that, and a worker in the company named Mary Stillwell, and I gets married to me. After I had a great idea to build an invention factory, I built it in Menlo Park. In the lab, I built a better and improved telephone from Alexander Graham Bell's. While building that, I came up with a machine that can record sound of a phonograph. I didn't really take that invention so seriously, and I invented something more genius called the electric light bulb.
Yeah,
it was a very affordable way of getting light, so many people wanted it. After that, a tragedy happened. My wife, Mary Edison, died at only 29 years old. I was so sad I left Menlo Park and I never wanted to return. My friends met me with Mimi Miller, and we got married within 6 months after she died. After I got married, I built a bigger lab in West Orange. I went back to working on the phonograph for 2 more years. After that, I invented the kinetoscope, which was like a moving picture camera with a hole the viewer would look through. I invented the world's first moving picture theater called the Black Maria. Black Maria. When I got older, I befriended inventor Henry Ford. Henry Ford realized it was almost the 50th anniversary of the light bulb, and he reconstructed the lab at Menlo Park at the Ford factory. When I saw it, I was quite moved, and I sat down for 10 or 5 minutes that nobody spoke. Then I said it was 99.5% perfect, and I told him the half that was not perfect was we never kept it so clean. After the speech, I collapsed on the floor. My health never improved, and I died on October 18th, 1931. For my honor, every light in the country was turned off for a minute, including the Statue of Liberty. I am important to learn about because I created many important things we use today.